यू नो चीजें लाइफ में कभी कभी होती हैं ऐसे कि जो आप सोचते हो ऐसा होता नहीं है, बट रिग्रेट नहीं है कुछ लाइफ में. OTT पे आने वाला है सबसे पहले, सो आई वाज लाइक दैट्स इट, आई वांट टू डू दिस ईयर फॉर श्योर, एंड डेफिनेटली यू नो आई वांट टू टेक दिस एज अ अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रिवाइव और टू कम बैक विथ, यू नो. One was with Nagesh Kukunur, for which I had auditioned and got through, like, he had auditioned 500 guys and I got that movie. That was like a solo film, which unfortunately didn't release around that time because they couldn't release our film. This was back around 2010. And I also done Sudhir Mishra's movie, 2009, which again got stuck. It was all set to release. It had me, Soha Ali Khan was opposite me. They released Akshay Kumar's movie and then John's movie, but that didn't, you know, give them enough benefit. She's family to us. She's always been family and she'll always be family. And she's always supported me.
Joining me today is Karan Nath, who made his debut in 2002. But before that, he actually starred as a child actor in Mr. India. And since then, his journey has been quite a roller coaster in its own way. Karan Nath is going to enter the Big Boss OTT house this season. And welcome. Before you enter the house, I have had the opportunity to speak to you. So welcome to Bollywood Bubble, Karan.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you so much. Awesome. You know, you started off as a child actor in Mr. India. I mean, that's an iconic film in itself. Haan then ji. You made your debut, like a proper heroic debut in 2002. But then, uske baad itna, matlab, you know, your career did not take off as you would have expected it to. Are there any sort of regrets, Karan, if looking back?
No regrets. No, zero regrets in life. Because I feel life is a journey, right? Jo likha hai, wo hona hi hai. So, but you have to keep trying. You have to keep trying. That's all you can do. I started, yeah. As you mentioned, Mr. India mein tha. But I was too small to, mujhe aaj tak, mujhe abhi bhi yaad nahi main kya kar raha tha picture mein. But haan, jab picture dekhta to mujhe thoda bahut yaad hota, achha main ye kar raha tha, iske piche bhaag raha tha, uske piche bhaag raha tha. So, I was very small at that time. And then, uske baad, then I made my debut. I came in Ye Dil Aashiqan, a movie. I was in my teens. And that movie was like, big hit at that time. The music was also big hit, very well received all over the world. Phir uske baad, yeah, I mean, maine kuch picture kiye the, phir main gayab ho gaya kafi samay tak. Because I wanted to do something good, you know, quality stuff, and because I always believed in quality over quantity. Offers aate rehte the, but wo maza nahi aa raha tha. To isi chakkar mein phir aur time nikalta gaya. But I kept trying. Aisa nahi tha ki main ekdam, you know, chala gaya tha Bollywood se dur. Aisa nahi tha. Huh. But I kept trying. Then I did this movie called Guns of Banaras, and jisme thoda samay lag gaya tha, thoda time nikal gaya production and all that before it really. Then it released on apna last year, before lockdown, unfortunately. So haan, theek hai, koi baat nahi. You know, cheeze life mein kabhi kabhi hoti hai aise ki jo aap sochte ho aisa hota nahi hai. But regret nahi hai kuch life mein, kyunki main, you know, achhe khandan mein paida hua. जहाँ पर खाने पीने का प्रॉब्लम नहीं था, पैसों की प्रॉब्लम नहीं थी, तो फिर क्यों रिग्रेट? किस चीज का रिग्रेट? मुझे रिग्रेट नहीं है. हाँ ठीक है, अगर जो मुझे चाहिए मुझे मिला नहीं, बट कोशिश तो मैं कर ही रहा हूँ और मैं कोशिश करता रहूंगा. शायद बिग बॉस आके मुझे वो जो चीज की मुझे जो तलाश है वो शायद
मुझे मिल जाएगी. कि मतलब यू नो मे बी करण इज मेकिंग दिस कमबैक सो दैट ही कैन रिवाइव हिज करियर इन बॉलीवुड एज वेल. इज दैट द वाज दैट वन ऑफ द रीजंस व्हाई यू चोज टू डू बिग बॉस?
टू बी ऑनेस्ट, बिग बॉस आई ऑलवेज वांटेड टू डू बिग बॉस. लास्ट मेरी 2-3 साल से उनसे बातचीत चल रही थी, एंड दिस टाइम व्हेन आई केम टू नो दैट OTT पे आने वाला है सबसे पहले, सो आई वाज लाइक दैट्स इट, आई वांट टू डू दिस ईयर फॉर श्योर. And definitely, you know, I want to take this as an opportunity to revive or to come back with, you know, and especially for all those fans who over the years send me non-stop messages on social media and everything that please, you know, please come in some movie or come in Big Boss and stuff like that. This is specially for them.
This is a treat. treat for them.
Yes,
well.
Yes, definitely. Definitely for them. And I hope that I win the show. I will give my best. You know,
yeah, I'm sure.
Winning and losing, I guess that's all. That all depends on God.
Yeah, I feel eventually if you win people's heart, that is
that
what
is the most important thing. And how you win, you have to keep trying. And I will definitely keep trying. And I'll give my best. And I just want to set an example for other Bollywood heroes, for actors who are in my place, to take Big Boss as a relaunch or a launch pad.
Right. But you know, again, taking you back to the journey, because it always feels a little heart-wrenching also when you see that someone who has delivered a hit as their debut film, and then eventually the career doesn't take off as it was expected to. How did you deal with it back then? Because see, it's very easy for me to sit here and ask this question, but Anji, for you to be in that position wherein maybe you wanted good work to come your way, it wasn't coming, people had their own speculations, media easily writes people off
easily
so how did you wade your way through? How did you manage or deal with all of that back then when you were a teenager?
I think the very fact that I'm sitting in front of you all fit and fine, that's the way I dealt with it. I've always been very positive, and even if someone, you know, writes, I know, you know, some people like to just write about you, whether it's positive or anything for that matter. If so-and-so guy is missing from the scene from long time, then they're like, oh, he's not getting movies, there's that. They don't think that, you know, in my case, movies kept coming in, but I kept refusing because I don't want to do anything just for money. If there is content, if the production house is like top-notch,
great,
or
the
director is like fantastic, then obviously I'll do it. I did a couple of films around 2010. One was with Nagesh Kukunur, for which I auditioned and got through, like, it auditioned 500 guys and I got that movie. That was like a solo film, which unfortunately didn't release around that time because Percept Company, the movie, they were the production house.
Yeah. And
they went through quite a bit. They released Akshay Kumar's movie and then John's movie, but that didn't, you know, give them enough benefit. So they couldn't release our film. This was back around 2010. And I also done Subir Mishra's movie, 2009. Which again got stuck. It was all set to release. It had me, Soha Ali Khan was opposite me. So, you know, I mean, it's okay. But then after that also, you know, I never gave up. I kept trying. And a lot of time went into Guns of Banaras. But it's okay, you know, I mean, it's fine. I don't have any regrets or something. It's just that all these things, you know, the downers in life and the uphill and stuff, you know, it makes you more stronger. It makes you mentally very tough, and the patience to aapka badhta hi aur aage. So I think ye sari cheeze mujhe Big Boss ke ghar mein bahut kaam aayenge.
I am so sure, and I'm so happy to see you so positive, Karan, to be very honest, because nothing will make me happier than see your career take off from here, you know, because I think that you deserve that at the end of the day, that chance to prove yourself yet again. But tell me, also, I was asking all the other contestants, but to you, I don't think it would be a surprise because Karan Johar is hosting the show. But I'm sure you must have spoken to him a couple of times because somewhere you have been a part of this industry, right? But are you excited about this fact? Because this is the first time Karan is hosting Big Boss as well.
Yes, of course, I'm excited that Karan is doing this show because we know Karan. You know, we know how he is, how he goes about his shows and stuff. He's quite witty, you know, he's got a very good sense of humor. So in that way, maza aayega, it'll be good interacting with him. And I'm super excited, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, and also, I was just reading a couple of articles and a lot of people are saying, are making connections between you and Madhuri Dixit, because of course your father was her manager for the longest time.
They started together.
Together,
my dad started before her, but yeah, she has started her career with my father. Yeah.
So are you in touch with her? Maybe do you get to speak to her? What is it like?
She's family to us. She's always been family, and she'll always be family. And she's always supported me. Even last year when my movie came out, she was there for us. She supported us, you know. So she's always been there for us, and I'm really thankful to her for that. So she'll be super happy. She'll be happy when she comes to know that I'm going this year to this year's Big Boss. She's right now in America. She doesn't know about it, but we'll definitely contact her and tell her about this.
And Big Boss, have you watched the previous seasons? How much of Big Boss have you watched, Karan?
My favorite season is the 13th one, for sure. Because there were some friends of mine in it. And I saw the entire season. And I think it was the most talked about season as well.
Of course.
Yeah, definitely.
And who has been your favorite player, if I may ask?
Player in that?
Contestant.
Yeah, the one who won it, Siddharth Shukla.
Siddharth Shukla. Okay. So
because I loved his aggression. Yeah, very
Make
them manly. Yeah.
What is your strategy going to be like inside? Because Big Boss tests your patience and your emotional aspect, mental aspect a lot, right? So are you like sort of prepared that things will be said, your weaknesses will be used against you? Like, are you sort of prepared for all of that?
Honestly, I'm not thinking about all this too much. To be very honest, I don't have any game plan. I'm not going in with any game plan or strategies or something like that. I'm just going to play straight from my heart, the way I deal things in my real life. That's the way I'll deal inside the house. And that's my biggest challenge, not to lose myself. The way I am, I want to portray myself the same way in the house. So I'm looking forward to it, and it'll be fun. Loads of fun.
But Karan, thank you so much, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you inside.
It was lovely talking to you. Lovely interacting.
Thank you. Bye.